Welcome back to Maddie Loves Death Metal, where I'm not talking about death metal today. We're going to be talking about thrash and power metal. That's right. It's happening. Power metal has now infestated Maddie Loves Death Metal, and you're just going to have to fucking deal with it. So, it's a holiday weekend. Happy Labor Day yesterday. Hope you guys had a great long weekend here in the U.S. I am exhausted today. Back to work after a four-day weekend of traveling and celebrating my son's 9th birthday and all of those fun things. But today, I've got a CD box set I'm going to show you all that I've had for a little while. I got it from Heavy Metal Museum. Shout out to Gary. He is awesome. Awesome Discogs store that I buy from all the time. And then I've got about 5 CDs of power metal I'm going to show you. So I'll do the thrash metal first. And if you hate power metal, you can close the video and move on with your day. So I picked this up from this is a High Roller Records release that came out, was the end of last year, Tales of Morbid Brains. This is the Destruction CD book box set. They also came out with a picture disc vinyl box set, which I had no interest in getting. But I did get the CD one. It was a good price, and this is simply just a collector's item for me. I do not think that I will ever spin these CDs. In fact, I've never even opened them, but I will show them to you. I got this just as a collector's item. These are some of my all-time favorite albums. Just love this band as a whole. Probably my favorite thrash metal band outside of Creator. It was a good price, and I splurged, which I have not done in a while, so I got it. So band is out of Germany. You guys don't need to know anything else about Destruction. So High Roller put this out. It was limited to 666 copies. I've already read pretty much the whole entire book. I've been having a field day with it. I got 122. So it's 8 CDs. It's from their 1980s catalog, and then it also has live Dynamo open air bonus tracks, and then this is a 60-page book, and then there's also a poster. So I'll show you the poster, and then I'll deep dive into the CDs and the booklet here. The poster is huge, so forgive me if I don't get it all on camera. It is a big poster of the band and their bullet belts and all of their glory. This will probably live in the book. I don't see myself hanging that. And then in this booklet, let me scoot on out here, we have the first 4 in the beginning and then in the back. Now, they are the cardstock CD holders. I'm not a huge fan of those whenever they're in box sets. But for this instance, it works. It's similar to the autopsy book that I showed you guys. And this book is worth it, in my opinion. The book is simply phenomenal. They did a really nice job of this. It's very high quality. It's a really cool box set. Now, for the price is a little steep, I will say. I spent like $130 on it. No, Siri, I did not say anything to you. Chill out. The fuck, Siri? But I don't know. Like I said, it's a collector's item. So here are the first 4 CDs. Like I said, this is back from the 19. This is Bestial. This is their demo. And I think that they put a rehearsal on here too. So it's basically a comp, but this is their Bestial Invasion of Hell demo and then a compilation. Like I said, I have not opened these, so they're still shrink wrapped. I don't know if I will. Again, this is a collector's item. I generally don't buy things and not open them, but this is one of those things where I already own all of these on vinyl. I got all the new High Roller reissues of these. I've not showed them off on here, so I'll do an episode on that. Here is a Sentence to Death EP. Fantastic stuff, man. God damn, I love 80s thrash so bad. Eternal Devastation. Love this album. Classic album. Then Infernal Overkill. Again, love this album too. Just top-notch, perfect music in my opinion. And then the final 4 CDs here. In my opinion, these are, you know, mandatory in the collection. I do like a lot of their later CDs too, or their later albums. Their last album that they put out was last year. I was a pretty big fan of. I need to get it. But there's, you know, to me, they have a pretty solid discography. Or it's actually 2 years ago. Wow, that came out 2 years ago. What the hell? So yeah. Here's the Mad Butcher, and this also has some Eternal or Jesus Christ, bonus tracks from the Dynamo Open Air in 1987. So this is basically a comp too. But again, this needs no introduction. Y'all know this already. And then we have Release from Agony. Easily one of my favorite album covers. Just so weird. Then we've got Live Without Sense. One of the best live albums, in my opinion. I hate live albums. I generally don't buy them. But this one is so goddamn good. I love this one. Actually, I don't think I bought the vinyl for this, so I might actually crack open this CD and listen to it. I know that they reissued this on vinyl. I have to check in. I don't think I have a package coming, and I don't remember if I bought that one or not. And then Cracked Brains. I like this album a lot too. So, 80s Destruction is undefeated, man. I'm such a huge fan of all of their 80s output. Again, I do like a lot of their middle discography and their last album they put out, but this is just cream of the crop here. And then the book itself is simply phenomenal. Very nice quality. Pictures are awesome. It goes into detail about every release. And it has all of these amazing images. It has the lyrics. They did a phenomenal job on this. Like, just the look at that. Look at that! It's amazing. Just the images alone. It's just such a cool collector's item. Yeah, I'm just a huge fan. I had to get this. Again, they made a picture disc vinyl version. I believe there's also a tape box set out there too. I don't remember who did the tape box set. I don't think it was High Roller. I'm blanking on who did it. But this one just was, just really wanted it for the book. So, goddamn, look at that. Such an awesome book. I'm so happy. I've been smiling ear to ear. Like I said, I've already gone through and read this all. But I will pack this away nicely on my shelf. And from time to time, crack it open and look at it again. I've done that with my Autopsy one. I have a couple of other book box sets too, that are not metal. They're just other classic rock editions that I've gotten in the past. So yeah, I love collecting books about bands and music. I have so many of them. I got to get the new Scott Burns book. I keep forgetting to order that. So there you go. So it's phenomenal. Definitely worth the cost in my opinion. However, I can see why some people wouldn't want it, but I love this box set. So pumped that I have it. So it's easy to find. You can pretty much find it anywhere. I would not spend over $130 on it, just so you know. Yeah, it's phenomenal. So, all right, now let's move on to power metal. So you can close the video now. As you guys know, I've been dipping my toes in power metal, and this is the band that started it all for me, was Powerwolf. This album came out back at the end of July, Wake Up the Wicked. After I listened to the new Hammerfall release, I immediately was like, okay, Hammerfall, it to me is not power metal. That's more heavy metal. But this piqued my interest, and so I listened to the promo of it and fell in love with it. This is my introduction to Powerwolf. I know they've been around for a very long time. Are they? They're out of Germany, right? They have a lot of albums out. This is their newest one that just came out this year. Huge fan of it. Super cheesy, especially the first track, "Bless Him with the Blade." So goddamn cheesy, but I'm a fan now. So I am dipping into this discography. I bought this one shortly after Interludium, Ludium. These are both on Napalm Records. Actually, all three of these are. This was out a couple of years ago. I think this is a comp, actually. I can't remember. And then I also bought The Sacrament of Sin. These are the ones that I've actually listened to in full, have digested and bought. But I've since gone and listened to their first couple of albums that were out on Metal Blade Records back in the day. Just fantastic artwork. I know it's hard to see because it's so glossy or so glary. I love the Wolf artwork. So yeah, I've been really diving into this band. For the most part, from what I've heard of most of the discography, it's all pretty much the same. Not a whole lot of variance within there, but just fantastic theatrical power metal. I love Attila Dorn's lyrics and vocals. Like, his vocal style is just awesome, very theatrical. And this just is pretty much straightforward Power Wolf, based off of their previous albums that I've listened to. They don't go out of their way or do anything crazy or different, but it's still good and solid. So, as power metal goes, you can blame this band. And but then we've got, so these guys are coming to Tampa on Saturday, and opening up for them is this band, which you guys absolutely probably don't need an introduction to at all, Unleash the Archers. So when I saw they were coming to Tampa and I saw Unleash the Archers were opening up for them, I was like, well, let me see if this is something that I'll like. Let me see, because I've purposely avoided this band because of the name, and the fact that they had the power metal tag to them, and they've been suggested to me so many times over the past, and I've just ignored it. Well, this is their new album that came out not too long ago, Fantoma. Is that how you say it? And I fell in love with it. Immediately bought it, and then that same night bought their other release, Abyss, that came out a couple of years ago. Need to go back and listen to their other albums. They think they've got like two or three or whatever, four more. Three more, four more. Besides this, the band is out of Canada, but these are the two that I've listened to, and I'm totally sold on the band now. Brittany's vocals are phenomenal. Man, she has pipes. I love her singing, and that is what really sold this for me. This album is fantastic and is going to be very high up on my year-end list. I've been listening to it nonstop, but she is amazing. I absolutely love her voice. Like, that's what completely sold it for me. And just the rest of the band is so talented. They just write great riffs, amazing drumming. Just everything is so perfect for me in regards to this. So this album is phenomenal. I even made my wife listen to it. She dug it. She liked it. So I might go see them this weekend. I might, if I can swing it. We have busy weekends now that school and everything is back into full effect. Just something's going on, like basically almost every weekend with my sons. But yeah, and then Abyss is awesome. I love this album too, so I immediately ordered it. So like I said, I need to go back, check out the other four albums, but huge fan of this band now. So for the like 20 people over the last several years that have suggested this band to me, and I've completely just blew you off, I apologize. I will not be a stubborn old biddy anymore. I turned 40 years old and I went soft and am listening to quote unquote wimpy music, as Aaron over at Metal Theologian often says about things that he plays. It's not wimpy music at all. It's really good. Power metal, I understand, is hit or miss. Not everybody enjoys it. So again, you're gonna have to deal, because it's gonna be on this channel, I think, quite a bit, especially for another video, because I fell in love with another power metal band and I actually bought their whole entire discography that night to listen to it. So that'll be in another video. But yeah, this is the CD collection update that I've been meaning to show you guys for a couple of weeks now. That's all that I have this week. Lots of new videos this week. I finally, I'm gonna pull out my High Roller Records reissues that I've bought over the last couple of months that I haven't shown off on here, or that I kept and just never sold. There's a couple that I got like towards the, like, after I found out I lost my job, I pre-orders and they came and I just never got rid of them. But I'll show them off. It's a lot of old school traditional metal and thrash that I just love and I want to dedicate more time to on this channel, not so much just death metal. So that's all I have. See you guys in the next one.